28 February 2017, the police invaded while the commissioning ceremony was about to be over. Of the new headquarters, the police invaded the headquarters, forcefully took over 55 of us from that office, and sealed the office since then. And thereafter, profiled charges against me and incorporated for sale of the Peace Corps before the Federal High Court. But on week before then, we filed instituted a fundamental human rights enforcement suit at the Federal High Court before Justice John Soho, no, before Justice Gabriel Kolawole, and in a well-considered judgment delivered on the 14th of November, Justice Kolawole held, in a landmark judgment, vindicated the organization by ruling that the action of the police is illegal, unconstitutional, null and void. The court further gave a consequential order to the police to vacate the office with immediate effect and also to award damages of 11.5 million naira against the police to be paid to the Peace Corps of Nigeria. Naturally, in a civilized crime, we expected the police to obey the court order instantly and vacate the office. They never did. Then the police also attempted through their OC legal in FCC command in a matter they've already handed over to the Attorney General of the Federation to prosecute. The OC legal sneak into the court, file a motion of notice for temporary forfeiture of the property. A property that we leased for 5 years. It's not our property. They didn't even bother to conduct a painstaking investigation to know who actually is the owner of the property. And their conclusion that since we are the one occupying there, that we just deployed with fraudulent money. But we are lucky that the court went into the merit, Justice Jones, who happened to be the Chief Judge of the Federal High Court, now went into the matter, look at it with the document we annexed, the lease agreement, the receipt. And based on the counter motion we filed, the court dismissed the motion they filed for temporary forfeiture and went ahead to order police to vacate that property since February 2018. In the last 3 years, despite subsisting court orders and judgment that has not been vacated by any court, the former Inspector General of Police with classical impunity refused to vacate the property. Last year, our lawyer was for the former Attorney General of the Federation, Chief Kanu Agabi, SCM, wrote to the Inspector General and the Attorney General of the Federation, drawing the attention that to the fact that the police is here to comply with subsisting order of the court. I think the whole journey toward the reopening of the office started from there, where a lot of meetings were held between police and the office of the Attorney General on the matter, leading to the court, the Attorney General finally giving the directive on Friday last week that the police should vacate the place with immediate effect in compliance with the two subsisting court order. That is what led to the police now obeying the court order and vacating the premises. Then beforehand, I want to also painfully recall too that the same advice that was given to this IG that he complied was given twice to the former Inspector General of Police to vacate the property, and he refused and nothing happened to him. So what I'm trying to say in essence is like, we commend the new Inspector General, the current Inspector General of Police, for his respect for the rule of law, his disposition towards obeying court orders, and his respect for the dignity of the fundamental human right of the citizenry. If you remove these three, then there should be no reason why we are practicing democracy. There should be no reason why we are a constitutional state. Then we also thank the Attorney General of the Federation that maintained consistently his position, obey court order and vacate. That shows that he is truly committed to the rule of law and respect for the bench,
okay,
which we highly commend.
That's very good. So this institutional police is known to be very knowledgeable on community policy. to what extent are you working together to infuse your agency with this call by various regions to have their security outfits? Are you looking at that possibility, knowing that it is very good in community policy? And you have an outfit which is called Nigerian Peace Corps. Are you working towards working together with them?
Well, it's not us, it should be them. And in my, while I was at, after the inspection of the premises yesterday, I addressed the press, and in the course of addressing the press, I told them that we have put the crisis behind us. We salute what the IG has done, and we have put the crisis behind us. We are not even noting any grudge or animosity towards the police or any individual. In the spirit of nation building, we have put the past behind us. And we did, and I did say that what we are looking up to now is how to embark on institutional confidence building with the police and other government agencies, related government agencies, towards having institutional synergy. It's left for them to open their door for us when we're ever willing and ready to serve our fatherland in any capacity. And if you look at the kind of training our officers were subjected to, when before the crisis happened, police trained our officers on report writing and documentation, you understand me, even crime identification and how to put up report. The SSS at inception was also training the rule of in the provision of social security, you understand me, in Nigeria. The national retention also trained our members, road safety. So our people have got, our members nationwide has gathered the way with us to complement the effort of the police. While we are more strategically placed, it is not a regional organization. It is not a religious organization. It's not an ethnic-based organization. There is virtually no community you can go to in Nigeria today that you won't meet officers. You can conduct a finding, go to any local government. For now, we have offices in all the state of our federation, the state capitals. We also have offices in most local government in Nigeria now, and we are in the various world. So the government can take us, but we are putting up a proposal to the National Security Advisor and the Inspector General of Police. As a matter of fact, I'm talking to you now, a letter is going out. I just signed it yesterday to the Inspector General, requesting that we want to have audience with him. One, to thank him, and also to explore the opportunity of us complementing their effort at the local government level, at the community level, neighborhood level. And by the time that is done, honestly, crime situation will not be what you come, you react to, but what you proactively retain.
Okay. Recently, we saw the sergeant of your Peace Corps.
I think it's going forward. As far as we are concerned, the House of Rep is at the level of being the clause by clause. How did they call it? At the level of the committee of the whole, to go through the bill clause by clause, with a view to adopt same. Then at the level of the Senate, it was recently introduced by distinguished Senator Ndume and scaled through first reading. So at that level, we don't know the next step that Ndume may wish to take. But as far as we are concerned, the bill is making significant progress in the two chambers.
Are you hopeful?
Very, very hopeful. It's a bill, it's not a new bill, it's a bill that was passed. The law, the extant law of the National Assembly, is that which you know better than I do, is for it to be adopted by this thing so that they can assume full responsibility. It's not being taken as a new bill.
What would you say with this course of coming up with?
Satisfied sort of, and I don't know any result, the reservation about it, if it will not be hijacked and used the way BSEC, all these state electoral commission are being used. You understand me? As long as it's not done, it's tailored towards the intention for which it is created, to secure life and property, it's okay. Because I've traveled widely. In America, for example, they have federal police, they have state police, they have even county police, that even though they are established for area council here, well trained, they know all the nooks and crannies of the area council. But if you ask them any question about Buhari, they don't know. So what I'm trying to say, the various developed countries of the world, in order to tackle challenges, security challenges, come up with different initiatives. Look, once the society is dynamic, security management and arrangement should change in tandem with how the society, the evolution of society. If we have the belief that it is how we started is what we put in place that we must use to tame security insecurity, honestly, we will continue to witness the kind of challenges that we are having now. Therefore, I expect the federal government, vis-a-vis the security agencies in particular, to open their door. What happened to us is not because we committed any crime. You understand me? It is the fear by the former Inspector General of Police that if this is not, he said it, and we have it on YouTube, that he will not allow it to be because social agency came and took part of their job. Most of the concern of the heads of the security agencies now is to rather secure their own interest, that is, secure the interest of the of their various agencies than rather than the overall interest of the citizenry. It is not done that way. We must be very rational, we must be very open, we must be very accommodative on issues that border on security. That is the only way we can come out of the situation of finance now.